Acromegaly is a rare and potentially life-threatening disorder, and it is diagnosed later in adulthood. It occurs due to the excessive secretion of growth hormone during adulthood. It is essential to say during adulthood because if it occurs during childhood, it causes gigantism and not acromegaly. The most common cause of this disease is pituitary adenoma. In pituitary adenoma, a tumor develops in the pituitary gland and it causes the excessive secretion of pituitary hormones. Growth hormone stimulates the growth of almost all the tissues in the body. We will have a separate video on growth hormone also. Excessive secretion of growth hormone causes the enlargement of body tissues and body organs. However, acromegaly does not affect the linear growth because the epiphyses of all the long bones are fused during childhood. So the acromegalic patients have normal heights. Most of the signs and symptoms are growth defects, such as thickening and hardening of nails, deepening of the skin creases in forehead, and changes in facial features. Enlargement of bones, especially in hand, feet, and facial bones. Wide spacing between teeth, oily skin, and excessive sweating. Enlargement of the lower lip. Enlargement of nose, enlargement of the kidneys, joint pain, muscle weakness and fatigue, vision impairment, and deepening of voice, and it is due to the enlargement of vocal cords. As acromegaly affects almost all the tissues in the body, it causes complications in body system functions. Now let's see some possible complications that can arise in acromegalic patients. Respiratory complications are increased lung capacity, that is due to the enlargement of lungs, airway narrowing, and acute dyspnea, that means shortness of breath. Cardiovascular complications are hypertension and left ventricular hypertrophy. Valve stenosis also can be seen in some people. Neuromuscular complications are nerve root compression, carpal tunnel syndrome, spinal stenosis, and muscle weakness and fatigue. reproductive complications are erectile dysfunction in men, menstrual irregularities in women, and loss of interest in sex in some people. Treatment is done by a surgery to remove the tumor. And this surgery is known as the endoscopy transnasal transsphenoidal surgery. During this surgery, the surgeon works through the nasal cavity and the sphenoid sinus to remove the tumor. That's why it has got the name endoscopic transnasal transsphenoidal surgery. When the surgical therapy is not possible, radiation therapy is used to remove the tumor. And for some people, they are given growth hormone antagonists such as Somavat.